Welcome to my channel. Today's lesson topic: the Peninsular Plateau of India. The Peninsular Plateau of India is a subtopic of the major Indian relief features for class 10th English medium social studies prepared by me, K. Charanjeevulu. ఎన్పిహెచ్ఎస్ ముచ్చువలు శ్రీకాళహస్తి చిత్తూరు డిస్టిక్ ఇట్స్ ఫర్ 10th క్లాస్ సోషల్ స్టడీస్ లెసన్ నెంబర్ 1 ఇట్స్ ఏ సబ్ టాపిక్ ద పెనిన్సులర్ ప్లాట్యూ Before going to explain this concept, we should know about the difference of between peninsular and island. I mean island. The definition: a peninsula is a long, narrow piece of land which sticks out from a larger piece of land and is almost completely surrounded by water. Like this, India is a peninsula. The western side Arabian Sea, southern side Indian Ocean, eastern side Bay of Bengal. So we call India is a peninsula, plateau, island, a piece of land surrounded by water. Like this, all sides, four sides are surrounded by water. For example, Sri Lanka. The Peninsular Plateau is a tableland composed of the world crystalline igneous and metamorphic rocks. It was formed due to the breaking and drifting of the Gondwana land and thus making it a part of the oldest landmass of Gondwana. This is Peninsular Plateau. It's the biggest major relief feature in India. The plateau consists of two broad divisions, namely the central highlands and the Deccan Plateau. The part of the Peninsular Plateau laying to the north of the Narmada River covering a major area of the Malwa Plateau is known as the Central Highlands. The Central Highlands are wider in the west but narrow in the east. The eastward extension of this plateau are locally known as the Malwa Plateau, Bundelkhand, Bagalkhand and Chotanagpur Plateau. The Chotanagpur Plateau marks the further eastwards of these central islands. It has very rich minerals. It's a rich minerals area. The Deccan Plateau is a triangular landmass that lies to the south of the River Narmada. This is river Narmada. The Deccan Plateau is located in the south of the Narmada River. The Satpura Ranges flanks its broad base in the north of the Deccan Plateau. Say the Satpura Ranges flanks its broad base in the north of the Deccan Plateau. Here, the Deccan Plateau is higher in the west and slopes gently eastwards. The Deccan Plateau is higher in the west, is tilt towards the east. So that's why all the peninsular rivers are drained into Bay of Bengal. So that is the reason all the peninsular rivers are drained into Bay of Bengal. Why? Because that is the reason the Deccan Plateau is tilt towards the east. That is the reason. The Deccan Plateau extends centrally of the Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats, mark the western and eastern edges of the Deccan Plateau respectively, and northern side Satpura Ranges. So the Deccan Plateau, the Deccan Plateau is look like triangle shape. Western Ghats lies parallel to the western coast. They are continuous and can be crossed through passes only. Locate the Thal Ghat, Bhor Ghat and the Pal Ghat in the physical map of India. The Western Ghats are higher than the Eastern Ghats. Their average elevation is 900 to 600 meters. The Eastern Ghats stretches from the Mahanadi Valley to the Nilgiris in the south. The Eastern Ghats are discontinuous and irregular and dissected by rivers draining into the Bay of Bengal. For example, Godavari, Krishna, River Basin. The entire Godavari Krishna River Basin, the Eastern Ghats are disappear. The height of the Western Ghats progressively increasing from north to south. The highest peak including the Annai Mudi 2695 meters and the Dodabetta, its height 2637 meters. So in South India, highest peak is called Annai Mudi, are located in Annamalai Hills in Tamil Nadu. The Nilgiris in the south locate the famous hill stations of Udagamandalam, popularly known as Ooty, and the Kodaikanal. These are the hill stations are located in South India, famous hill stations. The Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats are connected at the southern side of at Nilgiri Ranges. The Aravalli Hills lies on the western and northwest margins of the peninsular plateau. The Aravalli Hills lies on the western and northwest margins of the peninsular plateau like this. Here Aravalli, you are looking Aravalli ranges. These are the oldest mountain ranges in the world. There are highly eroded hills and are found as broken hills. They extend from Gujarat to Delhi in the southwest northeast direction. Here the difference of Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. It's a very important question for examination point of view. Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. They lay along the Arabian Sea, stretches from Tapati River to Kanyakumari in the south. These ghats are continuous and can be crossed through process only. For example, Pal Ghat, Thal Ghat, Por Ghats, and the average height of Western Ghats is 900 meters to 600 meters. Western Ghats is sources of many large rivers like Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Penna. The same sense, Eastern Ghats are they lie along with the Bay of Bengal of eastern side. And it stretches from Mahanadi Valley to the Nilgiris in the south. These ghats have been divided into several parts by large rivers like Godavari and Krishna. The average height of eastern ghats is 600 meters. And no big rivers originate from the eastern ghats. This is about the differentiation of Western Eastern Ghats. You should understand. Some more detailed explanation of text as given in this slide. My dear students, pause the video and note the entire text to your notebooks and for preparation of for your future examination point of view. Here, the Deccan Traps, it's a rich in black soil. The peninsular plateau has two main divisions, the central highlands and Deccan plateau. These are the main division of the peninsular plateau is divided into two major parts, that is central highlands and Deccan plateau. So I hope you are understanding well this please subscribe for more videos of social studies. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and share my videos. Thank you for watching.